Welcome to our home here at London's Heathrow Airport. You join me at our engineering facility, and this is a Boeing 787 Dreamliner. It's the first of a large fleet ordered by British Airways to replace our Boeing 767 and 747 fleets. I'd like to show you some of the aircraft's innovative features and take you behind the scenes. So join me for an exclusive tour of the Dreamliner. The 787 isn't made of aluminium like most previous airliners. This aircraft is made of carbon fibre composite. Carbon fibre has been used extensively in the aviation industry for years, but this is the first airliner to use it as its primary structure. That means the aircraft is lighter and more efficient, which means it produces less engine emissions, and also, most notably for those on the ground, it means it's quieter. The aircraft is also what Boeing call a more electric aircraft. That means that systems that you would normally expect to be powered by hydraulics and bleed air from the engines are actually powered electrically. Until recently, it has been impossible to build an airliner wing like this. By selecting carbon fibre and using cutting-edge aerodynamic techniques, Boeing have built a wing which produces lift with less drag. It's also more flexible than before. This means that the aircraft is more comfortable for the passengers in the cabin, and also the wings bend up into a characteristic shallow U-shape when seen from the front in flight. Don't worry though, this is completely safe and the wings are supposed to do that. The slats at the leading edge of the wing are high lift devices which we use at the same time as the flaps on the back of the wing during takeoff and landing. On previous Boeing types, the anti-icing was provided by engine bleed air. On this aircraft, they're electrically heated. British Airways has selected Rolls-Royce to supply the engines for its Dreamliner fleet. This is a Rolls-Royce Trent 1000 engine built in England near Derby. It produces 69,000 pounds of thrust. The engine is a key part in every aircraft to make it efficient and quiet, and Rolls-Royce have worked extremely hard to introduce innovations to this engine to keep it quiet. One of the key features of the engine is this serration here on the back. That helps to mix the exhaust gases and reduces the noise produced by the exhaust stream. You can see that there's two distinct streams in the engine here. This is the bypass stream where the air comes straight through from the fan, and this is the core where the fuel is burnt and the turbine extracts the power to turn the fan. At takeoff, the high pressure turbine blades in here are each producing more power than a Formula One car. Like other Trent models, this is a three-spool engine. Most people are surprised at just how big the wheels on an airliner are. These wheels are fairly conventional, but just behind them, the brakes are a real departure from traditional aircraft systems. These are electrically operated, not hydraulic, which means that there's greater redundancy, lower maintenance costs, and easier health monitoring. To the pilots, they work in exactly the same way by operating the pedals or the autobrake system. From here, you can see just how smooth and shiny the aircraft fuselage is. You can also see that the windows are bigger than you would expect. Because of the material that the fuselage is made from, Boeing have been able to make much bigger windows. Here's the British Airways Union flag livery on the tail. I think it looks really smart. This aircraft was built to replace the Boeing 767 and physically is very similar in size. However, because it's much lighter, you can fit more cargo on board or carry more fuel and go further. So we've had a good look at the outside. Now let's have a look on board. Here we are in the aft galley. As you can see, it's really spacious. Moving up into the World Traveller cabin, you can see our new World Traveller product. The in-flight entertainment features audiovisual on demand, which means we have a wide range of films and television programmes which you can pause and rewind. We also have USB connectivity such that you can view your photos on the in-flight entertainment screen. Also, there's laptop power at every seat. The passenger experience on this aircraft benefits from a number of improvements. It's quieter, the cabin altitude is lower, the windows let you choose the amount of light you let in, and the lighting can be set to different times of day, helping to control the effects of jet lag. The humidity will also be higher than previous aircraft, giving a much fresher feel. All this means that after a long flight, passengers and crew should notice that they feel more refreshed than before. We don't have pull-down blinds on this aircraft. Instead, each passenger can electrically lighten or darken each window, and in addition, the cabin crew can control them all. This is our premium economy product, World Traveller Plus. We offer this on long-haul flights for passengers who are seeking a more enhanced experience for a more peaceful trip. As you can see, the cabin is only four rows long, and the seats offer more space. This is our Club World cabin, our business product. This cabin offers exceptional levels of comfort and service, as well as access to exclusive airport lounges. As you would expect from British Airways, all the seats turn into fully reclined flatbeds. We've set out this cabin in a 2-3-2 layout. On long-haul flights where we carry extra crew, We have a crew rest area. This contains two bunks and a seat and allows us to have some sleep or some time off task. It really does help with our alertness. Don't be alarmed though, if we use this area, there's always two pilots on the flight deck. This is British Airways' new simulator flight training facility. Behind me is the Boeing 787 simulator, and beyond that is the Airbus A380. You can also see a movable wall, which will move up stage by stage as we bring each of British Airways' simulators into this building. First of all, we've got these really big displays here. This one at the moment is set to a navigation display, and as you can see, it's much larger than you'd expect from a normal airliner. If I press this button here, it puts what we call the ICAS, or the Engine Indication and Crew Alerting System, onto this side, and the other side becomes the really big nav display. If I just put the ICAS over to the other side again for a moment, and I wind the range right down, you can see that we give it a few seconds, and the airfield map will appear on the navigational display. This is very useful for being able to taxi at complicated airports or for when the visibility is poor. On the bottom of the navigational display is the what they call the vertical situation display. This shows us the flight path from the side and is very useful for terrain awareness and situational awareness. You can also see we have a head-up display here, which again helps with situational awareness as it allows us to see outside the aeroplane as well as see the information from the primary flying display, both at the same time. This is the electronic flight bag, or EFB, and it gives us a number of functions. We can use a technical logbook on this for the aircraft, we can show our arrival and departure plates, and we can use it to calculate our takeoff and landing speeds and to calculate the performance of the aircraft at different airfields. I hope you enjoyed this glimpse of our new aircraft. If you haven't already seen it, have a look at our video of the new Airbus A380. I look forward to seeing you on board one day soon.